at Kalemegdan Park, I believe, which is situated right near the fortress. And we're here to visit the zoo.
We're going to the zoo, apparently. Yeah. This zoo has the oldest alligator in the world, which was gifted to Belgrade by the US in what, like the 20s or something?
Yeah, I think like the 1920s maybe?
I don't remember, like a long time ago, but this is one old gator.
Yeah, he's really old. We'll probably find out how old inside the zoo. They also have a tiger, I think, like a special kind of tiger.
Ooh, okay.
So I'm really excited for that. And I think I remember our tour guide saying that this is the only zoo in the world that's situated inside a fortress.
Yeah, that's awesome.
So, yeah, I guess enough yapping. Let's head into the zoo.
Let's check it out. Cost 600 dinar per adult, which for the two of us equated to roughly 16 Canadian dollars ish. I'm just guessing. But here we are, we're in the zoo. Here's the map. It looks bigger than I expected, honestly. Oh, they have elephants? Oh my god.
Oh.
Okay, this is gonna be a good one.
I see the tiger.
The eye of the tiger. A little conflicted, you know, because it's like we see some animals here that are clearly being like rehabilitated. They look like they were injured somehow and now they're here, and this is a safe space for them to, you know, recover and have a place where they won't die in the wild, you know. But at the same time, there's also like you can tell some of them are really like not happy, you know. I remember reading the other day about a thing called zoocosis, which is like psychosis from being cooped up in like a small place for a very long time. You kind of go crazy. Some of the animals here are exhibiting symptoms of that, according to what I saw on the internet. The primary symptom of zoocosis is when an animal will pace the perimeter of their enclosure just over and over and over again with no rhyme or reason to it. They're just going back and forth mindlessly, and yeah, so it's kind of a bummer to see that. But at the same time, like, I don't know, other enclosures are better off. Some of the birds of prey, their cages feel kind of small. It's just like I know that that's probably not ideal, you know. So just if anyone could give me information on maybe these are temporary enclosures and they're getting released after they are healed or whatever, I'm not sure. But at the same time, I've had my doubts almost. I don't know. But one of the pros is that the zoo's beautiful and they have such a huge variety of animals. It's like a wonder to see them, you know? And like, you know, you'll see and you can get so close to them, which is like good for us, probably bad for them at the same time. It's tough, you know? Thank you. So we got some hippos here, and I've seen videos of hippos flipping cars, and this little put together wall is supposed to stop that from happening.
Walking through the whole zoo, it was really amazing. I think it's probably like the most diverse zoo I've ever seen. And another thing about it is you get so close to the animals, like a lot closer than other zoos we've been to. Like at one point we were literally like 3 feet away from a cheetah with only like a chain link fence separating us. Another thing is because it's in the fortress, this has been like the best workout we've ever had at a zoo because there's just a ton of stairs and ramps. But it just adds to the experience, so it was really neat. But yeah, so we left the zoo, glad we came, and now we're gonna head out to get some food before work.
Sandwiches. I grabbed one of these sandwiches yesterday and it was one of the best things I've tasted in a long time. So freaking good. So I went overboard and I got four from this guy here. So yeah, I'm excited. It's really tasty. All right, that was a fun day.
Yeah, it was really nice. We just finished our trek home.
Yeah,
our 14 flights of stairs.
So many hills.
Yeah.
My goodness.
It was a really great day. Loved the zoo. That was really fun. It was a little sad to see the animals in their little prisons.
But still, but magical to be there.
Yeah.
You know, at the same time, it's up and down, you know.
I just realized we forgot to see the alligator. The big alligator.
Do you think the one that we saw one, it was off to the corner, it wasn't very big and it didn't look super old?
No, I don't think that was it. I think maybe it was sick or something. I don't know.
We'll look up a picture on the internet or something. But like, dang.
Oh, we totally forgot. Well, I was most excited for the tigers and they did not disappoint at all.
Yeah.
But yeah, I guess we forgot about the alligators.
Oh, it's okay. My favorite animal was probably, what were the mini cheetahs? What were they called?
Servals.
The servals.
Oh, they were so cute.
Yeah.
There were so many. There were like maybe four serval exhibits too. So that was amazing.
Yeah, that was awesome.
Yeah.
I think every zoo we go to, my favorite animal is the one that reminds me the most of Gizmo.
Yeah,
so.
The cats.
Yeah.
And it's funny because you'll see them like stretching out with their bellies up in the sun or like licking their paws. And it's like, oh my gosh, Gizmo does that. But yeah, I think that's it for today. We're going to enjoy our sandwiches.